Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 4.2, Problem 3. This is Problem 3 from Section 4.2. It says find the maximum output for the simplex tableau shown below and state the value of the variables that will produce that maximum. So we have a simplex tableau that has four rows. The top row is 1, 3, 1, 0, 0, 0, 12. The second row is 2, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 10. The third row is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 4. And finally, the bottom row is negative 2, negative 1, 0, 0, 0 again, 1 and 0. Now, in order to maximize this, what we have to do is find the correct pivot and pivot the tableau and see what happens if we have more negatives in the bottom row or if we're done. So, to find the pivot element, what we have to do is first find the pivot column by finding the most negative value in the bottom row. Now, in the bottom row, I have two negative values, negative 2 and negative 1. Negative 2 is more negative than negative 1. The negative 2 occurs in the x1 column, so the x1 column will be my pivot column. Now, I have three choices for what my pivot element will be. There's a 1 in the top of the x1 column, or pivot column. There's a 2 directly beneath that, a 1 beneath that. Any one of those could be the pivot. There's a negative 2 in the bottom position. It can't be, the pivot can never be negative. So which one of the values in the x1 column is my pivot element? To determine that, you look at the ratios of right-hand side value of a pivot column value and go with the smallest positive ratio. So in the top row, I have a ratio of 12 for right-hand side over 1 from pivot column. 12 over 1 reduces to 12. In the second row, my ratio of right-hand side value over pivot column value is 10 for right-hand side value over 2 for pivot column value. 10 divided by 2 reduces to 5. And in the third row, my ratio of right-hand side value over pivot column value is 4 for right-hand side over 1 for pivot column. 4 over 1 reduces to 4. So the choices for my ratio are 12, 5, or 4. And I want the smallest positive ratio. 4 is the smallest of those options I have available to me. It's smaller than 5, smaller than 12. So the 4 occurred in the third row. So going back to my pivot column, my x1 column, the value of the third row down of the x1 column is a 1. Now, in order to pivot a matrix, what you have to do is turn the pivot column into a 1, and then turn the rest of the column, turn the pivot element into a 1, turn the rest of the pivot column into zeros. Now, just by a little bit of good luck, the pivot element is already a 1. That saves us a little bit of work. So as we start the next matrix, I can just start making zeros. So I'll put a line under the initial matrix, or initial tableau, and start the next matrix. So what I want to do is zero out all of the x1 column, the pivot column, except the one in the third position down. So in the top position of the x1 column, I have a positive 1. So I'm going to zero that. I'm going to have to make a new top row in order to do that. And next to the top row, I'm going to write a little equation, row 1 equals some stuff plus the old row 1. And I start my little equation with row 1 because that's the row I need to make the zero in right now. I end the little equation with row 1 because it should begin and end with the same row. And now what I left as stuff is the row with the pivot element, which for this particular problem is row 3. And it has to be multiplied times the same number but opposite sign as what's becoming a zero. What's becoming a zero is a positive 1. So the same number opposite sign would be a negative 1. So the equation I'm going to use to make my new row 1 is row 1 equals negative 1 times row 3 plus the old row 1. Now as I go through the different columns and do that to each value of row 1, in the x1 column I have negative 1 times row 3 is negative 1 times positive 1. That's going to make a negative 1. Add that to row 1. So I'm going to add negative 1 to positive 1, which will make a 0. Next, I have the x2 column. Negative 1 times row 3 is negative 1 times positive 1 again, which will make a negative 1. I'm going to add the result to row 1, so I'm going to add that result to 3. So I'm going to add negative 1 plus positive 3. That comes out to 2, positive 2. The next column is labeled S1. So in the S1 column, I will have negative 1 times row 3, which is negative 1 times 0. That's 0, and you're going to add that to row 1. So you're going to add to a positive 1, 0, and positive 1 is 1. The next column is S2. So in the S2 column, I'm going to do negative 1 times row 3, which is negative 1 times 0. That makes a 0. I'm going to add that 0 to row 1, which also has a 0 in it. So I add 0 plus 0, which is 0. The next column is S3. So again, I do negative 1 times row 3 will be negative 1 times positive 1. That's a negative 1. Add that result to row 1. So I'm going to add negative 1 plus 0 is negative 1. The next column is Z. So negative 1 times row 3 is negative 1 times 0, which is 0. I'm going to add that result to row 1. So I'm going to add 0 plus another 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. And the last column is the RHS column. I'm going to do negative 1 times row 3 is negative 1 times 4. That's minus 4. I'm going to add that result to row 1, which has a 12 in it. So I'm going to add negative 4 and positive 12. Gives me a result of 8. So I have a new row 1 that I completed. Now, moving down to row 2, in the pivot column of row 2, I have a positive 2. I have to make it become a 0. So again, I'm going to come up with some type of an equation that I'll write next to row 2 and use that equation to make a whole new row 2. That equation should be row 2 equals some stuff plus the old row 2. Now again, the equation I'm going to use, I start it with row 2 because at this step, that's the row that I'm making the 0 in. And I end the equation with row 2 because it should begin and end with the same row. Now the blank spot that I left in what I called stuff is the row with the pivot element, which is row 3 for the problem I'm working on, and it's going to be multiplied times the same number but opposite sign as what's becoming a 0. What's becoming a 0 is a positive 2, so the same number opposite sign would be a negative 2. So the equation I'm going to use to make my new row 2 is row 2 equals negative 2 times row 3 plus the old row 2. And as I do that in the x1 column, or the first column I have to do, negative 2 times row 3 is negative 2 times 1. That makes a negative 2. I'm going to add that to row 2, so negative 2 plus positive 2 is 0. The next column is the x2 column. Negative 2 times row 3 is negative 2 times 1, which is minus 2. I'm going to add that to row 2, so minus 2 plus 1 is negative 1. The next column is S1, so negative 2 times row 3 is negative 2 times 0, which is 0. And I'm going to add that to the value in row 2, which is another 0. So I add 0 plus 0, that result is 0. The next column is the S2 column. I'm going to do negative 2 times row 3, which is negative 2 times 0. That's 0. I'm going to add that answer to row 2, which has a 1 in it. So I'm going to add 0 plus 1, which is 1. The next column is row 3, S3. So negative 2 times row 3 is negative 2 times 1. That's negative 2. I'm going to add that to row 2. So I'm going to add negative 2 plus 0 is negative 2. And the Z column is next. Negative 2 times row 3 is negative 2 times 0. That's 0. Plus row 2, so plus another 0. 0 plus 0 gives me a 0. And the last column is the RHS column. I do negative 2 times row 3 is negative 2 times 4, which is negative 8. I'm going to add that answer to row 2, which has a positive 10 in it. So I'm going to add negative 8 and positive 10 is 2. So that completes my new row 2. Now as I move on to row 3, row 3 has a pivot element in it, so I don't want to change row 3. I'm going to just copy row 3 the way it is. Nothing will change, so row 3 will be 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 4. It will stay unchanged. And finally in row 4, I need to make a 0. The value I need to zero out is the negative 2 at the bottom of the x1 column. So next to row 4, I'm going to write one of those little equations. And it will be row 4 equals some stuff plus the old row 4. Now again, that equation is starting with row 4 because that's the row I need to make the 0 in. It ends with row 4 because the equation should begin and end with the same row. And now what's the stuff? The stuff is the row at the pivot position, which is row 3 for this problem, times the same number but opposite sign is what's becoming a 0. What's becoming a 0 is a negative 2. So same number, opposite sign would be positive 2. So the equation I'm going to use to make a new row 4 is the new row 4 equals positive 2 times row 3 plus the old row 4. So now, the first column, the x1 column, positive 2 times row 3 is 2 times 1, which is positive 2, plus row 4 is plus negative 2. So I have positive 2 plus negative 2 is 0. And now the next column is the x2 column. I have positive 2 times row 3 is 2 times 1, which is 2, plus row 4. So I have positive 2 plus negative 1 is positive 1. The next column is going to be 2 times row 3 is 2 times 0, which is 0, plus row 4, so plus another 0. So I have 0 plus 0, that's 0. The next column is the S2 column. 2 times row 3 is 2 times 0, which is 0, plus row 4 is plus 0. So again, I have 0 plus 0 in this column, which is another 0. The next column is S3, so now 2 times row 3 is 2 times 1, which is a 2, plus row 4, so I'm going to have positive 2 plus 0 is positive 2. The next column is the Z column. 2 times row 3 is 2 times 0, which again is 0. Take that answer, add it to row 4, which has a 1 in it, so I'm going to do 0 plus 1 is 1. And finally, the RHS column. 2 times row 3 will be 2 times 4, which is 8. And you take that 8 and you add it to the value in row 4, which is 0. So I'm going to do 8 plus 0, which is 8. So now I've completed the pivot. I have a 1 for the pivot element. I have zeros for the rest of the pivot column with the work that I did. And now the important question is, am I done pivoting or do I need to pivot again? And the answer, fortunately, is I am done pivoting. The way I can tell that I'm done pivoting is when I look at the bottom row, there are no negatives in the bottom row. If I had negatives in the bottom row, I would have to pivot again. My bottom row has no negatives in it. Now again, there are a few negatives in other places in the matrix. That doesn't matter as long as they're not on the bottom. So we found the maximum. So now we have to state what that maximum is and what value of the variables produce that maximum. So let me write underneath, I have enough room. So, maximum of 8. Now the maximum is 8. The output is always in the bottom right position of your tableau. So we started with a maximum of 0 because it was in the bottom right position in the first tableau. And it went up to 8 in my final tableau. And I can see that I can't make it any bigger because there's no more pivoting to do. So the maximum is 8. And it's just coincidentally the biggest value in the tableau. That's not why it's the maximum. That's a coincidence. And what values of my variables will produce that 8? So underneath maximum of 8, I'll put when x1 equals. Now, when I go to the x1 column of my final tableau, it does have a special column of all zeros and a single 1. So it has a value. The height of the 1 will tell me where the answer for that variable is in the RHS column. So the height of the 1 in the x1 column is 1 up from the bottom. So if I go to the RHS column and go 1 up from the bottom, it's a 4. So that's the value of x1. x2. The x2 column of my final tableau does not have a special column of all zeros in a single 1. So its value is 0. Now, if you like, you can also state the value of the s variables, the slack variables, but you don't have to. If you're curious, s1 is 8. Because in the S1 column, I have a special column of all zeros in a single 1. The height of that single 1 is in the top position. And as I look in the RHS column, in that top position is an 8. That's why S1 is 8. S2 also has a value, because in the S2 column, you have all zeros in a single 1 in the final tableau. The height of the 1 is 1 down from the bottom. So in the RHS column, 1 down from the bottom is 2. So S2 would be 2. S3 does not have a special column of all zeros in a single one, so the value of S3 is 0. But you don't have to write the S. You can if you want to. You have to write the X, though. So the final answer for this question is maximum output of 8, when x1 is 4 and x2 is 0.